السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brothers and sisters everywhere and anywhere, Ramadan Kareem, and may Allah make it a blessed and rewardable month for all of you, wherever you are, whenever you are. Today I'm going to talk about the role of Muslim in Ramadan, especially at the time when we are in a very big conflicting crossroads. The own personal role, personal duty, and the rest will be community duty. The personal is the worship from fasting, prayer, reciting of the Quran, standing up at night, the whole night, and making dua for Allah. This is absolutely personal duty. Has to be done not only at Ramadan, but in Ramadan outside of Ramadan. Community duty, some of them will be a part of the personal duty. Our work. During Ramadan, we should do more work. We should earn more money. We should invest more in our companies and our workers, in our trade, and so on and so on. We should give more to everybody during this month. We should not be feeling lazy, having the headache and the backache and the dizziness and the feeling the thirsty and the hunger of the fasting. Number two, for the community as well, we should be pioneering. Ramadan is not the month of no thinking or stop of thinking. How can we become a pioneer and innovative individuals by mixing and connecting and listening and absorbing and comprehending the problems of our society without understanding our problems, our society will never be able to actually become innovative pioneers. Number three is renewal. Renewal means actually reshuffling the knowledge at the back of our mind. Renewal of our ideology, philosophy, values, culture, moralities, and manner. We should keep always renewing all this sort of thing, because Islam was never was a very traditional, static religion. It was and should be a dynamic religion that affects and impacts the societies and the individuals believing in Islam and surrounding societies, inshallah. It is a month of construction or building. Construction and building of what? Of our society. By building the individuals, by building the organizations, by building the partnership between this society, this organization and others, by building between different cultures, the bridges between different cultures and different philosophy of thinking, all these kind of things, it should be a part of our duty. Number six, jihad. Jihad now become nowadays a taboo. No, jihad in nafs, which is one of the most important thing when you resist the desire of your soul, and you reform your soul, and you control your soul, and you could change your soul from this weak soul into the satisfied soul, the soul which is very, very, very satisfied with what it has. Resist backbiting, scandal mongering, lying. Feeling arrogant, having the ego, if we have a big organization with a lot of money, all this kind of sickness of the heart will lead to hellfire and azabullah. Number seven and the last is the link, as-sila, silatul rahim. To be very good for your mother, your father, your family, your neighbor, your brothers, your sisters, your wife, your uncle, your neighbors, and the non-Muslim neighbor, and so on. So even if your non-Muslim mother or non-Muslim father does not talk to you, go and talk to them and visit them. Sila, it is from the Rahim, and Rahim is from Rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 7 points: worship, your work, your innovation, renewal, constructing and building your society, jihad al-nafs, as well as as-sila, which is building the link and the bridge between you and the others. جزاكم الله خيرا وكل رمضان كريم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.